Who's the greatest of all time? Is it Mike Tyson?
Muhammad Ali is the greatest of all time.
Muhammad Ali, then Mike Tyson.
It depends on who you are.
You know, I travel all over the world, and when I ask people, why'd you get into boxing, they all tell me Mike Tyson.
Absolutely. Really? Absolutely. That's what I'm saying. It depends on the person you ask, right? Using that to be holding.
Very grateful. Right. I have a lot of gratitude.
Okay. Yeah. You're a big boxing fan. Joe Goosen told me you're a great analytical mind. Who are some of your favorite fighters in the world of boxing?
Well, there's only one. That's Muhammad Ali. You know, he's my hero, he's my idol, he's my inspiration. All my life, I admired Muhammad Ali when I was in high school, city wrestling champ, Chicago, Dunbar. Muhammad Ali, a teacher knew Muhammad Ali, brought him to the school. Then I had a chance to meet Ali when I was a sophomore in high school. Then how my life intertwined with Muhammad Ali. Later on, I became Muhammad Ali's bodyguard. One of them, he had a couple of them, he hired me. Then how my life changed again. That was the second time. First time I met him in high school. Second time, I was his bodyguard for a couple of years. And then the third time in Rocky III, if you remember the house that Rocky was in, you know, that was actually Muhammad Ali's real house.
Wow,
you know,
I didn't know that.
So we interacted again. You know, got a chance to talk about the old times and stuff like that. Muhammad Ali, he's just been an inspiration, not just boxing, but as a black man, giving young black guys hope, telling them that you can make it. You don't have to do drugs. You don't have to be bad and all that, you know. So all most of my stuff, it comes from Ali, you know, because he's just special. He's just special.
For people who did not know Muhammad Ali, you knew him personally. We heard everything. We've read every book. We've seen every movie. What can you tell us about him that nobody knows from your experience?
He was a fighter from all angles, from inside, spiritually, mentally, psychologically. Whatever it was, whatever phase it was, whatever it affected, he prevailed. And if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be talking to you now.
Wow.
We've become friends. And a friend. He's an incredible friend. Times we have dinner together. Just Muhammad, we've become friends. And a friend. He's an incredible friend. Times we have dinner together. Just talk. He gives me advice about life, about boxing, about everything.
Best advice you got from him?
He said, boxing's independent. It's good to have good people around you, but you are the person that should maintain everything. You know, don't give up. Don't throw away your money. Don't be controversial. I'm not explaining it properly because the way he said it to me, it was just from the heart.
Boxing superstar Alexander Usyk not only shares the same birthday with Muhammad Ali, January 17, but he's also won the Ring Magazine belt 3 times, just like Ali. Check it out.
And he's saying, I want to bring peace to the world. So Muhammad Ali was more than boxing. He was more than a sportsman. He was about real world issues.
And they were born the same days.
Born on the same days. That tells you something. It's cosmic.
Sasha, you know Muhammad Ali also had that belt.
Muhammad has three pois.
Yeah, and Ali has three belts as well.
Ali has three pois.
I love it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Much respect.
For what?
Good man.
For the fun of it, yes.
Have you ever met Muhammad Ali?
I met Ali once.
Well, how old were you?
I met him in 1991. I'm going to tell you exactly what it was. The 20-year anniversary of him and Joe Frazier. They had this big dinner in Philadelphia. And I went. And I was standing in front of the door, and I was, you know, my mom was talking trash.
Were you a champion then?
I was getting ready to fight. I won the title that year from Simon Brown.
Yeah.
So I was talking trash, and the door behind me opened, and there was bright lights. So I'm like, what the hell is everybody getting quiet for? I turned around, and Ali was standing right behind me. I almost pissed myself. And I just looked at him, and then he looked at me and smiled.
He knew who you were?
No, he didn't know who I was. So now they go to the podium. It's him, Joe Frazier, Howard Cosell, they all sitting on him. So I go up to shake his hand, and his bodyguard stopped me. And he said, no, let him come shake my hand. And I said, I just want to let you know we got the same birthday. And he said to me, you're a bad man.
What's the birthday?
January 17th. He said, you're a bad man if you got the same birthday as me. That made my year right there, man.
That's it.
That was it. I got to be the greatest, man.
Did you know that Buddy McGregor had the same birthday as Muhammad Ali?
No, I didn't.
I got the same birthday as Jimmy. Jimi Hendrix.
Look at Funky. George Foreman, Joe Frazier, Ali, and Buddy McGriff. All in the same month.
Reporting. By the way, guys, Jake Paul also has the same birthday as Muhammad Ali, Buddy McGurk, and Usyk. Here is Muhammad Ali telegram that he sent Dr. Martin Luther King. Check it out. We're friends. And in November 2nd, 1967, Martin Luther King was arrested in Birmingham, Alabama, put in jail. And Muhammad Ali was banned from boxing because he wouldn't serve in Vietnam. So Muhammad Ali sent Martin Luther King this telegram, and it reads, "Hope that you are comfortable, not suffering. Muhammad Ali." Two great men. So I'm sharing with you some videos. Here's Vinnie Curto, sparring partner and friend of Muhammad Ali. Check it out.
I'm here with Vinnie Curto, the former sparring partner of Muhammad Ali. And today he's going to show us how Ali used to move.
Strength was his common sense. Like every great trainer, his common sense. If something's working, you go with it, like Angelo Dundee. Ali did this. Let me show you. Ali did this. This is taboo in boxing. Look, Ali did this. He'd move around the ring. Now watch. He'd move around the ring. He'd be moving around the ring, and all of a sudden, the guy get near him. He'd do this. The punch would go that way. Then now they would step over here. Boom, 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 boom. Right. Now that's taboo. You're going straight back. That's taboo. You go straight back. You know what most fight trainers would tell you? Like Yancey Durham, Eddie Futch, Chuck Telhami would tell you, right? A blind man can hit you going straight back. All he has to do is throw punches and follow you to the ropes, he's gonna hit you. Right? But Ali made all kinds of mistakes that worked. So Angelo went with it. It's called common sense. Right? Common sense
says. He didn't change you as a fighter. He didn't change you.
All the stuff that you did that was weird that worked, he worked off of that. He never said anything about any negatives you had, as long as they were doing good. I remember when I was fighting Briscoe, I was stepping back, I was fighting Benny Briscoe, and he was in great shape, but I was stepping back, going over the top, bang, and I hit him a double left hook in the body, boom, boom, right? And instead of stepping over, like you should, to get out of the way, I was doing this. I was doing this, and I put my hand in his face, then I turned back this way, boom, boom, right? That's very dangerous with a punch like him. That's very dangerous, and a turn-up, you know, very dangerous. Angel says, do that again, I like what I saw there. Tell me that last move, do it again, I like what I saw.
When you sparred Ali, show me how Ali moved when you were sparring. What was he doing to you?
Here's me.
Yeah, that's you.
That's me, and that's exactly what it was. he was in front of me and he'd do this. And he'd throw 5 or 6 punches. You know the way. Oh, the beep, 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 and all of a sudden, beep. He throw it. Just touch me. No power, nothing, right? And then I'm a middleweight. He's like 230 pounds, 6'3". I'm a middleweight. He was faster than me, way faster than me on my feet, right on his feet. And he was more fluent with his punches. The guy was inhuman. The only way with a young Ali. And can you imagine those 3 years that he lost when he didn't go into the service? Let me tell you something. Ali, the years proved that he was correct. The years proved. He believed in his convictions, and he stuck by them, and that's the way he was. And look at him. The greatest heavyweight ever lived. There's no greater heavyweight.
And you have to respect people who stand up for what they believe in.
Stand up for what they believe in. And look what he did. They exiled him for three years from boxing. His prime years.
Yeah, in his prime, he stepped away.
The prime 3 years. Can you imagine what he would have did in those 3 years? He sat on his behind for 3 years, but he believed what he... Then he came back and whooped everybody. Then he came back. How do you... Think about that. In the last three decades...
What's your favorite Ali saying? Mike Tyson has one. Everyone has a game plan until they get hit in the face.
Yeah. Like I told you the last time we had an interview. Every man is my teacher. I can learn from anyone.
That's it.
So stay in college. Get the knowledge. Stay until you're through. If they can make penicillin out of moldy bread, they can sure make something out of you.
So there you have it. Vinnie Curto. Stay tuned for more.
God bless you, Muhammad. I'll never forget what you did to me in front of that school. Right? God bless you, man. God bless you. Angelo, you know what? Angel's up there making matches. You got plenty of fighters up there to make matches with. Anyways, I, um, I personally want to thank you again for what you've done for me. You changed my whole life. And the moment I went to your training camp, my whole life changed.
And my son liked this belt.
Why do you think that is? What is it about the Ring Magazine belt that even the kids and people who don't even follow boxing, they love it?
Так багато людей і взагалі і особливо діти полюбляють цей пояс.
Я не знаю, тому що він гарний і це ж пояс, який дається людьми. Не асоціацією, а людьми, які вибирають кращого спортсмена, правильно?
First
of all, я думаю, що він і best.
First of all, it's good looking.
It does look good. It's a good looking belt.
The second thing about this ring is that it's not about sanctioning bodies. It's about it's a people's choice. So it's not given to you by someone from the organization. It's
very true.
It's from the fans' heart.
And we don't take your money. We don't take 3%. This is your third Ring Magazine championship. Obviously, you won the Ring Magazine title when you became undisputed cruiserweight champion. That same year, 2018. That same year, Fighter of the Year, Ring Magazine Fighter of the Year. Yeah. So he has a Fighter of the Year championship belt. So quite a collection. Let's see what you look like. Why don't you stand up and try it on.
Давай подивимося, як він на тобі виглядає.
Олександр, and then a proper interview. There we go. That's how a champion holds it.
This big story in the news is championship belt when he beat George Foreman sold for $6 million. And it's crazy because I thought that belt should belong to the family, to him. But I guess Bandini had it in his locker. The locker went for sale after he passed away. Someone bought it and auctioned it off. The owner of the Colts bought it. $6 million.
Listen, you shave him in the corner a little bit.
No, man, listen. Man, they used to have guys so good. They used to have a third dice in their hand. Guys are so good at cheating at dice. I don't know if you can find anybody, man.
They play everywhere.
There's some serious dice rules.
I was outside of Mayweather gym. They were playing when he was in camp.
See, I don't get in the dice game. No.
Me?
That's a fight. That's a fight right there. Especially if you lose.
I bet your Floyd will be winning every time.
Not, hey, man. You get some guys get hot.
But you got all the money. So like,
you can have all the money. You get a guy that's hot, man.
It doesn't matter.
Oh, that's true.
Have you ever met?
There'll be nobody team after that.
Ellie Seckback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.